Hi, I'm Rick for TGW.com, and today we're excited we get to reintroduce the new for 2019 Pro V1 and Pro V1x golf balls from Titleist. And the Pro V1 and the Pro V1x have been the number one ball in golf for years. So how do you improve the number one ball in golf? That was the question. Titleist went to their tour staff players and asked them that same exact question, and the answer basically was, you don't. We love the performance with the golf balls around the green. We love the precision with our scoring clubs. We've got all of our clubs dialed in. We really don't want to change anything other than give me a little more distance off the driver. And that's exactly what Titleist did. We got to hit the new Pro V1 and Pro V1X, and I want to talk to you about my first impressions, like always, unboxing the product for the first time, hitting the product for the first time. I'll tell you about the performance that I saw when we got to test the two golf balls. And then we'll show you the technology that gave us that performance. Also new for 2019 is that the Pro V1 and the Pro V1X are available in high optic yellow for the first time. The golf balls maintain the same dimple patterns. Looking at the golf balls, you wouldn't see anything different. The Pro V1X continues forward with red numbers versus the Pro V1 stays continuous with black numbers on the golf balls. The only thing we could notice looking at the golf balls is the ball identification where it says Pro V1 or Pro V1X. In previous models, it was black outline with black fill. This year's 2019 Pro V1, Pro V1X have a gray fill with black outline on the ball identifier. So you have to look close, but it is easy to differentiate the 2019 from previous models looking at the identifier on the side. So the testing, we were really excited because again, the Pro V1 and Pro V1X are known for their performance. I hit my sand wedge, I hit a 7-iron, and I hit drivers. We got to compare this year's Pro V1 to the previous model. And we got to compare this year's Pro V1X to the previous model Pro V1X. Starting first with the Pro V1X, the wedges were virtually identical. I wouldn't be able to tell you which ball I was hitting when it came to the wedge. And the same holds true with the 7-iron. But here's where it gets fun, is when we switch over to the driver. Now I swing the driver just under 100 miles an hour, maybe 97, 98 miles an hour. On average. This year, going to the new Pro V1X for 2019, my ball speed on average went up 1.7 miles an hour. In fact, on my best shot, it went up 4 miles an hour. So on average, almost 2 miles an hour, but on some shots, almost 4. And while that doesn't sound like a lot, by maintaining the spin, by maintaining that 15 degree launch angle, I was getting about 3 yards on average more carry. And while that doesn't sound like a lot, that's maybe going to put me a half a club closer to the green. Next, we got to try the Pro V1. And again, being a high spin player, the Pro V1 golf ball is a little bit more suited for me. Again, we're maintaining the same feel, flight, and spin characteristics. When it comes to that, the Pro V1X, the highest spinning, the Pro V1 is going to be moderate spin. Being a high spin player, jumping down to the Pro V1 was the better option. Ball to ball with the wedge, 75.7 is the ball speed. Distances, again, we're right on top of each other. Moving up to the 7-iron, again, exactly the same thing. Ball speed's a little bit higher for me with the Pro V1 over the Pro V1X. They jumped up to 115.1. With the 2019 Pro V1, I was able to get 115.8. So about, again, a half a mile an hour added ball speed is all. On average, I was a yard farther. But looking shot to shot, and again, looking at the grouping, all of these balls are right on top of each other. The driver is where it gets fun. Again, I was seeing appropriate ball speed of 147, swinging at 98 miles an hour, getting 2,700 RPMs with the Pro V1. Jumping up to the 2019 Pro V1, my ball speed went up to 149.9 on average. So right at 150 on average from 147, that's a 3 mile an hour jump, and that's pretty significant. I did not see a difference in spin rate. It was stayed identical to last year's ball, but with the faster speed, the ball landed 9 yards further down the field. So even 3 miles an hour ball speed is going to put me nearly a club closer to the green. And if I can hit a 9-iron over an 8-iron or a 7-iron over a 6-iron, I feel like that's going to give me a better opportunity to score. And with the same greenside control that we've come to expect, we don't have to make any adjustments once we get to the greens. So now to the technology. How did Titleist find distance with just the long game? Well, the technology is in the design of the golf ball. Your driver is the club that's going to compress the ball the most. So as you're compressing that ball, you're really starting to interact with the core of the golf ball. Your wedge, on the other hand, with all the loft and the glancing blow, doesn't compress the ball at all, and it really interacts with the soft urethane surface of the golf ball. So what Titleist was able to do is come in and make the cover of the golf ball 17% thinner than previous year's models. That allowed them to come in and take the next layer, which is the casing layer, and actually thicken that by 14% over previous year's models on the Pro V1x and 11% on the Pro V1. So by thickening the casing layer and then re-engineering the 2.0 ZG core, they're really affecting the part of the golf ball that the driver interacts with while maintaining the great spin control that the short game takes advantage of. It's the thicker casing and the redesigned core that's giving you that better ball speed on just the long game while maintaining the performance and consistency with your scoring clubs. Now keep in mind why both balls are going to give you better distance in your long game, especially when it comes to your driver. Both of these balls maintain the relationship between feel, flight, and spin. The Pro V1x is going to be the firmest feeling golf ball. It's going to have the highest spin rates and the higher trajectory. The Pro V1 is going to be moderate spin rates, still very adequate, but a little bit more penetrating ball flight, not quite as high trajectory as the Pro V1x. So two great options to really dial in your flight and your feel preference while maintaining the spin control that you've come to expect. Titleist has done it again. They've taken the number one ball in golf and made it that much better. They're going to get us a half a club to a club closer to the green to increase our scoring potential. It's the new Pro V1 and Pro V1x from Titleist. They're available at tgw.com.